All right, we are back again. Section 4, part 4 of Wednesday, July 14th, 2010. And, you know, so far you've seen what we've been doing. We've had infinite spirit, when Lord Buddha, Lord Christ, this friend is coming through. He might have more to say. Whoever comes through, we're just going to, Jeremy's really too highly attuned to them today for some reason. So I've been the one asking questions and trying to keep that. I come up with ideas to ask of the infinite and Lord Buddha, but they come with their own stuff too.
Yeah, I feel like I'm going through like the infinite, then Buddha, the infinite. Sometimes Christ, we had some famous people talk to earlier in earlier videos. It's some reason today my vision is good.
Well, I guess we were just talking about that, you know, you have to come from the heart, you know. You come from the heart. Do what you love to do, what you feel you need to do from the heart, and do it without reservation. You know, do it without reservation, without holding back, and without worrying about judgments, you know.
Yeah.
Don't worry, you know, about what other people think.
You can almost be 100% that people are going to judge you, you know what I mean?
That's a fact of it. Yeah, people are going to judge you, but you got to be like, you know, you have to be like, have the Teflon man or woman. You know, people are going to throw eggs on you or whatever and try to shit on you and your work. But you guys got to have that Teflon coat on you.
Call
you crazy or whatever they say. But it just bounce off of you and laugh and just keep going. So that's what I try to do. Even our own families, you know, we have people in our own families that are unhappy with what we do.
Yeah.
But we don't care because we don't consider my DNA related family my family. It is part of my true family. Everyone is my family.
Yeah.
Everyone and everything is my family. And Jeremy's family, your family. You know, I don't think just because I happen to have some DNA in this particular body from a certain person in this world that's exclusive family.
Exactly.
You know, because I relate closer to a lot of other people and certain friends than I do even my own blood family. I wanted to say that, you know. So, but anyway, let's just keep going with where we were going.
Buddha was saying family is also within.
Mm-hmm.
You know, family is within. It's within you, you know what I mean? Like, if you, you know, choose, you know, well, you rely on the people you rely on, you choose the people you choose to, in your life to be there for you, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be, you know, the shoulder that you cry on doesn't have to be the mother or the father, you know.
Yeah,
maybe, maybe it was when you were a child, you know, and a baby and things, but, you know, you have choices now, you know. You know, we're family. We'll not deny you as family. Please don't deny us as family.
Yeah. All y'all watching this, you know, y'all are family too.
Yeah.
And spirits that we deal with, y'all are family too.
Absolutely.
You know, and they were all here. We're all one. You know, we're all related to each other through spirit.
That's right.
And
the infinite is the only thing that disconnects each other from each other is our own ideas of what makes us different.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's a human created thought.
Yeah, it's our own. Yeah, we did that. We, you know, it wasn't meant to be this, that, and the other.
We paid too much attention to differences.
Black, white, Hispanic, Christian, Catholic, or Buddhist, gay, straight, lovable, non, you know what I mean?
All of it.
It's so much to it, you know, like it's
all
not,
part of it.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, but the thing is, the differences were there, like the honor, I think they originally was there. All the different things, creations were there to honor the infinite spirit and what's out there, the different ways that the way the infinite's represented, you know? I think that's the real reason for the different appearances and stuff. And it's just like a way of expression of the creative force of prime creator, you know, the infinite, you know. But yet we as people, like, somehow manage to label everything and judge things and say this is better than that, and, you know, but it knows not originally is an infinite. I can see that.
It would be wrought, this Buddha said we would be wrought to live in our natural environment.
We would be what?
It'd be rough to live in our natural environment.
True.
Because we wouldn't have, you know, like a lot of things that we depend on. Well, we wouldn't have from the skid go, so it wouldn't matter, you know. What I'm saying is, like, you know, a lot of the things that we can run and hide from, you know, in our natural environment, we cannot, you know, we can't rely on authorities and laws, you know, to stop things from happening, killing, rape, you know, and all these things would not just keep going, you know. In our natural environment, you know, a lot of us would feel like violated and things, but the idea is the natural environment we could not live in, you know, not now, you know. So we have to figure out how to overpass this and love each other, you know.
Yeah. It's that's the most important thing.
We love each other. Well, I think I guess I'm commenting more myself in the sense about the natural environment thing, because, you know, like, well, then, you know, there's so much that we count on, and I don't want to just say law and authority, government, and things, but we count on our cars to get around. So many things that we count on, the food to be at the grocery store. You know,
and the electric to cut on.
Exactly, the water to.
Now, what if it all disappeared tomorrow?
Yeah, you know, we'd have to rely on ourselves more. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Being strong, and you know, no matter what happened to us or what happened to the people around us, there would be no psychologists, insurance, medicine to get out. I mean, think about it. You
have to figure it out on your own.
We learned to live to be 80, 90, 100 year old. You know, some of us, and, you know, lifespan back in thousands and you know, years ago, maybe 30, it's so hard to, imagine what we would do if we died when we were 30 or something, or something like that, you know, for a lot of people anyway.
Sure.
But the thing is that, you know, the lifespan is not even important. You know what I mean? What's important is yourself. It just keeps coming back to yourself. You know, doing for yourself, loving yourself. Let's have unity. Love each other. You know, love them. Why not?
That's right. And there's nothing weak with loving each other. You know, a lot of people think that it could be an unmanly thing to love one another, or it's something gay or whatever, or it's wrong. But yet, a lot of people love to say you love your friends, right? And your friends might be the same sex as you, same male or female, and they might say, yeah, I love my boys, or, you know, yeah, I love my boy, and this and that. Some people might say that. But yet, it's not turning you into a gay person to say that. But you can expand that beyond saying, I love my boys. You can say, I love everyone. Yeah. You can love the homeless man pushing the basket down the street, you know.
Yeah.
You can love your enemies, your so-called enemies, people you argue with. And it might be a good place to start with that. You know, that's something, of course, that's something said in the Bible, but there's truth to that. There is truth to that sentence about loving enemies.
Yeah, you're only responsible for yourself, what other people think of you. You're not responsible for.
Correct.
That's our infinite world, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's infinite world.
But yes, and it's important that you definitely want to give a high, you express yourself in a high manner, in a good high way, not in the lowest way. You express yourself using love, and you know, even if you don't get the response from other people, you still the best to use love as an expressive tool. I could recommend that myself, too.
Love, love, love.
You know, it's pretty important, the love. J. Jeremy's phone's ringing off the hook today.